just good. Here we are at Royal India. Is it into something?
My name is Alhussein Dhanani.
Alhussein Dhanani. The last name?
Yeah, Dhanani is the last name. Alhussein is the first name.
Alhussein is the first name. Yeah. And the last name?
Dhanani.
Dhanani.
Yeah.
How do you spell it?
D-H-A-N-A-N-I.
You're originally from Tanzania?
Yes.
You look at Africa. I've been talking about Africa, 55 countries. Are you satisfied that Africa is where it should be?
No, I'm not. It should be much ahead of what it is right now.
If there was one thing you could change, what would that be?
Rule of law.
Okay, why is the rule of law so important to you?
Because it gives stability and development in every other country.
But when they say the rule of law, isn't it an imperialist term?
Not at all.
An imposition by the British?
No, no, it just means a standard way of doing things.
Okay.
It doesn't matter which law. We are not talking about the British law.
Yeah.
We are talking about having consistency.
Okay.
Right? That we can follow.
Are you satisfied that there's a shared understanding in Africa of why it is important to have a rule of law?
Not at all, because the law keeps on changing.
So we're talking about banking on Africa's future.
Yeah.
If I say this idea of the rule of law ought to be one of our foundations in terms of banking on a future that is secure for everyone,
yes.
Would you agree?
Absolutely.
That absent the rule of law, they cannot be wealth.
Yes.
Wealth is a product of certainty,
yes.
Of the rule of law.
Yes, of stability.
If you were to look at Africa at midnight and you ask me three individuals who stand out on this idea, who celebrate this idea of the rule of law and its centrality, would you be able to identify just three names of people who are passionate about it?
Nobody yet. Maybe, I don't know. The ex-Ghanaian president, what was
which
his
one?
Name?
Jerry Rawlings?
Yes, one
okay.
of them.
What about somebody says he shot some people to get into power?
Hey,
and, and that's one is not rule of law.
Yeah.
But in the media, do you see anyone in the media, journalists?
I can back it up by saying that Mo Ibrahim has brought out this award for the leaders of Africa, and for the last few years he has not been able to award any of those funds to any leader. Because
but on the media, if you look at the media,
and
the fourth state, whatever, fourth branch,
yeah.
Do you see anyone who stands out in the media as a person who celebrates and who believes in this idea of the rule of law as a centerpiece?
You are talking about in the media?
In the media in Africa, when you look at the African media.
No, I don't. I haven't heard.
Okay.
I haven't heard.
But you have a lot of experiences where you know things can go wrong and do. Does the things do go wrong?
Yes.
Your country of birth, what has happened in Tanzania? We'll discuss that in detail.
Yes.
Yeah. But are you satisfied that Tanzania is where it should be?
It should be 100 years ahead of where it is right now. Absolutely.
Yeah.
We have everything in Tanzania. You know?
But are you satisfied that the voices, what you think is important, it's not happening on the ground. And how best do we accelerate or provoke people to think?
We just have to look at what successes we have had in the past.
Okay.
And replicate it.
All right.
From 1999 to 2005, we had 6 mines opening in Tanzania, every year for 6 years, because we had the best law. All we had needed to do is to copy that in every sector of the economy, and we would have been far ahead. Instead, we changed that law to suit the other laws where there is now no rule of law.
So you are concerned,
yes.
As a citizen,
absolutely.
but we could be somewhere where we are not.
Absolutely.
And you'll find our ways to the world. What did you say on this day? The 4th of the 4th of November.
Yes.
And the day before the opening of the investment conference. The African Investment Conference.
I would say that we need to make the environment an enabling environment, as we discussed earlier.
Yeah.
It is the investor, the human input, that makes resources, gives resources its value.
Yeah.
So we cannot say, oh, we'll just leave it in the ground and we'll dig it when we have the money. Yeah. No, that will never come. It is, we have to attract investment and make things happen now.
That's right.
Not tomorrow. And make it up with a strong rule of law that we discussed.
Thank you very much. If you are watching, if you are listening, and these are just voices of ordinary people who, through experience, they know what could be different. And today, Africa is not where it should be, and people wonder why. It is our missing voices that make Africa a dark continent. And we've chosen to be silent on what matters. And it's not politics to be able to talk about what is required to make Africa great. And it is us who can make that happen. Thank you.
Wow.
Yo, so many people are...